Hey there, hope you're having an amazing Saturday. Why don't you get on your phone and text out about five people, say, join Pastor Paula as she gets ready to do a quick Bible study, and then we pray together. I'm here at John's studio. He's downstairs. We're in Nashville flying back to beautiful Orlando, Florida, so I'll be at New Destiny tomorrow. We're having one of the most amazing saxophonists. It's going to be a powerful, powerful time. By the way, if you're ever in the Orlando area, join us at New Destiny Christian Center. We are really in revival. But I was just reading and doing study. I'm finishing up my book right now and downstairs meditating, studying, praying, and just seeking the Lord while John's working on his album that's coming out in May. We're excited about that. And I was in the Message version, and I was in Proverbs chapter 18, verse 21. And it says, and here's what I really want to share with you. Words kill and words give life. They're either poison or fruit. You choose. Think about this right now. So God says in Proverbs chapter 18, verse 21, and I read the Message version, which we're used to. There is the power of death and life in the tongue, King James Version. But I love the Message version. It said, words kill and words give life. They're either poison or fruit. You choose. You see, often it's not what other people say to you or say about you. It's what you say to yourself about yourself. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6 says, it's impossible to please God without faith. Now, the word please does not mean like, oh, God, are you happy with me? Am I making you happy? It means to be in alignment. Well, we know this, that God makes himself one with the Word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and God was the Word. So it's impossible to please God or to be in alignment with God without his Word working on the inside of you. So the question, when it's saying to you, you choose whether you're going to have poison in your life or whether you're going to have fruit in life, is do you come in alignment with what God is saying about you? Not what society said, not what your past says, not what the hater says, not what the devil says, not what your mother or father said, not what a pastor might say, what God has said. Do you come in alignment with what God says? You're the head and not the tail. You're blessed coming in and blessed going out. According to Isaiah chapter 53, verse 5, he was wounded for your transgression, bruised for your iniquity. The chastisement of our peace is upon him, and with his stripes you are healed. He declares that you are the apple of his eye, that he is constantly thinking about you, that you are more than a conqueror, that you already have victory through Christ Jesus, according to 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 57. That you are the ambassador of the Most High God, your delegated representative, that you have all authority both in heaven and in earth. That when you pray, your prayers are not only heard, but they are answered. That if two of you agree as touching anything on heaven and earth, that it shall be done. It declares that you speak to the mountain, the thing that rears against you, that looms against you, and it has to be moved. The Word of God declares that 1,000 will fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come nigh thee. That no weapon formed against you will be able to prosper. That God will give you a sudden defeat over your enemies. That you will increase the more and the more in favor, in stature, in wisdom, just as Jesus did according to Luke chapter 2, verse 22. And there's so many promises. Psalm 68, 19, that God will load you up daily with his benefits. Philippians chapter 4, verse 18, that he will supply all of your need according to his riches and glory. So whose words matter? See, language is a locator. So I want you to really listen to what you say. Oh, it won't ever happen. The doctor said that I'm not going to walk again. The doctor said that I'm going to die soon. It's not going to happen. My mom said I'll never be anything. My dad left me and abandoned me. My ex-husband said that no one would ever marry me. I break every word curse over you right now and take authority over it, whether it was placed as a self-placed embargo, something that you spoke against yourself, said against yourself that is not in alignment with God's word. Let it be overturned right now in the mighty name of Jesus, or any word curse that has ever been spoken over you, that you'll be barren, that you will not amount to anything, that you won't make it, that it's impossible. The devil is a liar. It is overturned right now by the superior blood of Jesus. God says he honors his word above his name. Think about that. When you speak the word, it is either life or death, Poison or fruit, you choose. So I just wanted to come to you with that little thought today and say, choose life. Choose fruit. Choose to speak God's word. Declare it, decree it. And according to Job 22, verse 28, it shall be established. Now let's pray together. And I just felt like right now, because it's easy to get kind of in a funk. It's easy just to speak that negativity over ourselves. I'm excited about the Unleash Conference too. May the 2nd through the 4th. So many great people are going to be there. You don't want to miss it. We're going to have Pastor Jensen Franklin, Lisa Bevere, myself, Terry Savelle Foy, Pushy Watson from South Africa, Prophet Gideon Donzo, Pastor Brad Knight, Ingrid Rosario, Kim Walker Smith, Jonathan Cain, a host of others. It's going to be powerful. So you can go to Paula White, www.paulawhite.org. Get more information. It's absolutely free, but the seating is limited. So I would encourage you to register. You can get preferred seating for simply $10. I mean, that's absolutely nothing. So remember Proverbs chapter 18, verse 21. I was reading the message version and it just hit me to share this with you watching all the way from Taiwan. It says that there is life and there is death. Words either bring life, they kill, or they bring life. They bring poison or they bring fruit. You choose. So in the name of Jesus, choose to say, I am the healed of the Lord. Choose to say, I am blessed coming out in and going out. Choose to lay your hands on your spirit, on your womb, and say, I am fruitful. Choose to declare your children to be ambassadors for the Lord Jesus Christ. Because your words, hey, Chris, love you, praying for you, mighty woman of God, you are healed. I love you. I declare that you are completely healed by the stripes of Jesus. Cannot wait. You will arise from any bed of affliction in the name of Jesus. Wanted to share with you. Please pray for your family for restoration. Linda, I declare you are restored. According to the book of Joel, that God says that he will restore everything that the cankerworm, the locust, the palmer worm, and the caterpillar have eaten. The Bible declares that the Lord will restore to you everything sevenfold that the enemy has stolen from you. So everyone, to restore means back again. Anyone who has lost anything spiritually, emotionally, physically, financially, relationally, that has been stolen by the hands of the enemy through some kind of demonic manipulation, declare restoration. Say, I am restored. I am the redeemed. I am blessed. All right, pray for one another, and I love you guys. Lots of new exciting things happening. Paula White Ministry, believing God to have our studio. I just declare the studio will be built debt-free. I will go back on daily television on I was on 47 networks before. Let's go for 50 networks. Everything that God has, that multitudes of millions of souls will be saved, that lives will be transformed, hearts will be healed, that God will use my voice stronger than ever before, and that he will raise up the laborers and those that stand to hold my hands. We can build our studio for $186,000 for the first step. It's $366,000. And I just declare $366,000 will come into Paula White Ministry, and the studio will be built before Unleashed Conference in Jesus' name. Amen. Decree and declare what you're believing God for. In the studio, it's not for me. It's for the gospel. So I know that God will do it. Love you guys. Love you, love you, love you. And I'm praying for you. Be blessed.